This is the Rumor Report with Angela Yee.
As we're watching this whole royal wedding that's about to take place this weekend, tomorrow, right, with Meghan Markle getting married, and it turns out that she is not going to have her father walk her down the aisle. Instead, it's going to be her future father-in-law, Prince Charles, that will take over these duties, all because Meghan Markle's father, as you know, is not going to be attending the wedding. He's sick. Well, Serena Williams talked about her own father not walking her down the aisle on her HBO docuseries, Being Serena. Here's what she had to say.
I think I got the text from my dad like an hour before the wedding was supposed to start. He was in New Orleans. He had a suit. And I know he was really excited. But then he wrote me and said, Serena, I don't want you to be mad at me, but I just can't walk you down the aisle. I'm not myself anymore. I'm too nervous. And I wrote right back, and I said, Daddy, it's okay. If you don't want to come to the wedding at all, that's okay too. I'm not going to be upset with you about it, so I don't want you to be upset about it.
What, he had anxiety or something?
Yeah, I thought they were cool.
He got too nervous.
Wow. Because, nervous about what? Walking his daughter down or being
so many
in front
people
of people?
Watching, really? He just got nervous. It's not probably what he signed up for in life. And
what do you mean? That's his baby girl.
Well, she's fine with it. As long as she said she's okay with it and she understood. She said maybe a lot of daughters wouldn't react the same way, but I know the struggles he's had these last few years and all of that. So she said his health is better, but I know he doesn't feel like himself. And he doesn't feel like he's perfect. So she
He could be having health issues. He could be dealing with really, really intense anxiety. You never know.
Yeah, so, and Meghan Markle, by the way, as we're getting ready for the royal wedding tomorrow, she's had all kinds of issues going on that have been very public. Her ex-husband was trying to pitch a TV show based on his relationship with her. People are betting on everything because, you know, they're really big on betting in the UK. Everything from what color, you know, whatever the bridesmaids are going to wear and all of that. So it's a lot going on. But, you know, she's been facing a lot of things, including racism, being the fact that she's biracial and she's American. People have a problem with that. So there's a lot going on as we get ready for this royal wedding tomorrow.
Who is we?
Everybody, because it's going to be live.
I ain't watching it.
Now,
get ready. They said that she actually was, her name was searched more than Donald Trump's here in the United States today. But they search Donald Trump all the time, and he's always at the top. And she actually overtook him for the first time because everybody is talking about, if you watch the news and everything, and a lot of little girls are saying, wow, that's, you know, it's a real-life princess now, and it's a woman who is a woman of color, which has...
I'm holding off for Cardi and Offset's royal wedding. Okay.
And, you know, Meghan Markle, she had to shut down her Facebook, her Instagram, her Twitter accounts, her website. She can't act anymore.
So? She got a castle now. She don't need all that.
She got a castle now.
But that's something that she worked for her whole life. So that's just part of what comes with it.
What time does it start?
Oh, I don't know. But, you know, it's in London, so there's a five-hour time difference.
No.
So they're 5 hours ahead of us. All right, now let's talk about MTV suspending Catfish. All because Neve is being accused of sexual misconduct. They're not going to film anymore while they perform this investigation. So details are still a little bit unclear, but there were two videos posted by a woman who appeared on the show 3 years ago saying that a man that she called Jack had made several inappropriate sexual comments. Now, Neve has denied these claims. He released a statement and he said the behavior described in this video did not happen, and I'm fortunate that there are a number of former colleagues who were present during this time period who are willing to speak up with the truth. I've always been transparent about my life and would always take responsibility for my actions, but these claims are false.
Oh, she said he made comments.
Yeah, I don't know exactly. Inappropriate sexual comments.
Oh, well, I mean, if that's the case, everything's recorded on Catfish. If she was actually on the show, everything's recorded.
Yeah, so a lot of people believe that this woman, Aisha Morgan, was referring to Neve when she was making these comments on tape. All right, Tierra Marie, in the meantime, has done a press conference, and she was with her attorneys, Lisa Bloom and Walter Mosley, and she is going to be suing. She's suing her ex-boyfriend, Akbar Abdulahad, and she's also suing 50 Cent. Here's what she had to say in that press conference.
Last week, I found out that my boyfriend was cheating on me, so I broke up with him. Right after that, he posted a sex tape. He had my Instagram password, so he posted them on my Instagram to make me look terrible. Then his good friend, 50 Cent, posted the obscene photo of me and said, get the strap. 50 Cent has 18 million followers. Even after Instagram took the picture down, he had no remorse, no regard, and he posted another photo and complained that IG was censoring him.
Where Where's the Get the Scrap t-shirts? 50. Why you don't got Get the Scrap t-shirts yet?
I'm sure they coming.
All right, now Tierra says this all was an attempt to slut shame her. It's caused significant long-term emotional injuries, requiring psychiatric services, and she's suing them for revenge porn, invasion of her privacy, and emotional distress.
I don't think that 50 should be held accountable for this because it's something that was posted online. A lot of people reposted it. Why aim at the biggest
but
fish
just because
you
can? But you remember that he lost with Rick Ross's baby mom when he posted that sex tape.
That was different, though.
I think he posted that first. He bought that and posted that allegedly. But this one, everybody posted.
Yes.
And not to say that posting it was right, but you shouldn't be able to sue him. You got to sue everybody.
Well, I guess we'll see what ends up happening. What she's saying is that he has so many followers that him posting it actually caused emotional distress for her and emotional injuries. So we shall see what happens. In the meantime, 50 Cent went to social media and he posted, I have an unscripted show idea that's going to blow you away now that I'm being pulled into a reality show storyline. LOL. Get the Strap. And then he posted Mona Scott and said, LOL Mona, like, yeah, we got the lawyer on Love and Hip Hop film. This ish, Get the Strap. So I guess he's unbothered. Ooh. All right, I'm Angela Yee, and that is your rumor report.
The Breakfast Club, every weekday morning. Tune in.